All right, I'm driving to Maracas Beach. Actually, I already took one wrong turn already, so I'll start the video again.
Slight left, then turn left.
The streets here can be quite confusing, to say the least. I think I am driving on, they consider this a roundabout, and they like to call it the largest roundabout in the world. But in Malaysia, they like to say they have the biggest, because this roundabout isn't very round, it's got an odd shape to it. So you could, do you consider this a roundabout? I'm not sure. You know. It's like a big loop that with a one-way road, so they consider it a roundabout.
In 500 meters, turn right.
If I remember right, this is a street where the Trinidad Carnival will pass through. I remember standing here as TGIF Fridays. I think in Queen's Park is a lot of the...
Turn right.
The Queen's Park is where a lot of the carnival stuff happens. Yeah, it's like my Google Maps is like turn right, but then it shows turn left, so it's not. Google Maps isn't doing very well here. This is weird. It's like it looks like a roundabout, but it's not, I think.
In 600 meters, continue straight.
I'm still getting a feel for my driving here, so that's why I'm not talking much. You know, I'm still trying to focus on the driving. It looks pretty nice here.
Exit.
I wouldn't be surprised a lot of these people are actually driving to the beach also, so. If that was the case, I'll just stay behind some people. Everybody turning, I don't know. This Indian music probably wouldn't give me a copyright violation, so that's why I'd probably just leave it on the channel like this. Now for YouTube. Today it's Sunday, 3:10 p.m. right now. No, I'm sorry, 1:10 p.m. So I started about 1 p.m. People just do some weird things. I'm sure we would like to pass this truck here. Okay, he turned off. Thank you. an incredible road right there. Driving here reminds me of driving in Jamaica. This guy's driving really slow. Come on.
In 200 meters, turn left.
This is insane how slow he's driving. can't be a local driving this slow. Rasta man, it's probably high as hell. Oh, there's a lot of cars behind me because this guy's driving so slow. I'm beginning to think he's driving this slow on purpose to piss us off. Wow, some nice jungles here.
Value, your customer-friendly supermarket gives you more value for your dollar.
If you look at Google Maps, all it shows is a lot of zigzags. It's not doing very good. Notice what some things that help keep me from getting bored when I travel is driving. So having this rental car is nice. I could just take a nice ride, drive, you know. And something else is being able to swim in the ocean. So if I have those two, I'm really happy with somewhere. Last couple times places I've been, I didn't have a rental car. Didn't have somewhere to swim and just kind of didn't like it. Tobago had somewhere. I went swimming there. I was like, wow, I really missed this. I didn't have a rental car though, but. At least here I have a rental car. It's nice to just drive. And the rental car is about $41 per day with no insurance, so it's not too bad. Using Ace Rental Car. I used them in Curacao and, you know, it came out okay, you know, so I'll try them again. They always have the cheapest price so far. Maracas Bay is about 4 kilometers, but where I'm going should be about 6 kilometers. Ocean, nice view. Be all downhill from here. Let's see what's on the radio here. More Indian music. That's what's on the radio. Radio is not very good here. Sorry, I have to concentrate on my driving here. I don't want to fly off a cliff. Basically, I'm driving to the Maracas beach. I'm gonna make a YouTube video there. I'm gonna, if it's nice, I'll walk around and make a YouTube video there. I'm gonna try a shark and bake. And then that's about it. I really wanna try one of those shark and bakes. Let's see what the beach looks like here. Whoa, this road. Whoa. Guarantee this song gave me a copyright strike. Here's not very good. I see a beautiful view of the mountain. Some mountains there. Got 1.4 kilometers. That's less than a mile.
example, of course, is a credit union.
Nice bay there.
How or what can be done to help the credit union movement? Well, for example, they have issues now with banks and the interest rates, the charge, and so forth, which in my mind provides an opportunity for the cooperative movement. But then you start to hear about legislation to restrict, and is that what is needed, or is there needed legislation to help
a variety of investment companies and financial institutions? Gentlemen, just report back to this. Persons who come up against corruption seem to become untouchable. Meaning those who hold authority in private and otherwise, don't want to come close to those persons, and these are the persons who come against corruption. I want to hear your point of view with respect to the whistleblower legislation that will protect those who want to see an end to corruption, because there are people who are seeing things even as we speak and in the past, but they are afraid to speak out because they know victimization, and they can be literally abused by doing so. You spoke just about the credit union movement. What is there to protect, to prevent corruption within the credit union movement? And I've seen massive corruption in the movement, and that what is preventing to even speak about it because of different connections and indicators. So the question is,
well, people talking about corruption. That's what's in the news.
And in respect to us really coming together to really remove this curse of corruption, where nearly everybody is becoming a point where everybody needs a kickback.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks,
Abby. I don't know if you want that. That steps out of your realm.
It steps out of my realm of expertise, but I'm not really aware of corruption, credit union movement, etc. But I think of corruption as a whole in general. We need greater commitment from the economic authorities.
Nice, beautiful bay here. Oh, nice.
Sorry, not just the economic authorities, but for the authorities in general at the state level. Government leadership at all levels. We need greater commitment from them.
I think finding a parking spot will be hard for me.
It all goes back down again to the quality of institutions. If you have better corporate governance structures in place, then that means you have better alternatives that go on in the country. We have anti-corruption laws, but in addition to that, we have to strengthen inspections as well. And the revenue authority is actually an authority that could facilitate that whenever it is set up. In order to strengthen inspections to make sure that we limit fraudulent activities and not just pertaining to tax avoidance, but you'll be able to pick up on certain unethical activities as well.
Increase penalties. Yeah. As well. All right. So we know you need to go shortly, because you say you have to be in Chaguanas for 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
Right. But listen, we needed to talk about the budget and coming budget, and I mean, we have a number of things here I wanted to ask you, but. You know, in a general sense, where do you think we're going with this budget? What do you think would be the
all right,
of the budget? The oil and gas.
I decided this is probably the easiest place for me to park. This is the easiest place for me to park. So I'll end the video here. I have to take the camera off my car.